here with Ed Morris at the
Pleasant Prairie Power Plant.
Also known as P4 for a very good reason. It's hard to say that one.
Yes.
We're going to see a number of things here today. Ed's going to tell us what's going on currently here at P4. Then also, there's a test project going on with Alstom with CO2, and that's going to be a whole separate conversation. But just to get things started, what's going on currently here at P4? I mean, what do we see behind us there?
Well, what we can see up here is the selective catalytic reduction unit, which is like a catalytic converter on
a car. Right.
And that removes 90% of the nitrogen oxide emissions. And then over to my right here, we added it on in the last 2 years. We added a brand new stack, and at the bottom of it is a sulfur dioxide reduction emission control system. It's called a scrubber.
So what I'm seeing, and just for my own benefit, I'm seeing technology in action when I see this plume.
That's correct.
It's not what people think they're looking at. I was never sure what I was looking at, quite frankly. So I mean, that's cleared it up for me. Why don't we keep going on and see what else we can, what else is around here?
Very good.
Well, we'll just head up this way.
This whole building, this would be the scrubber building. So it basically, the whole purpose of this is just in the processing of the removal of SO2 and the production of gypsum, which is used in wallboard.
So this is, in essence, an environmental retrofit to the existing plant.
That's correct.
And in this building particularly, we're talking about SO2.
Yes, and all of what you see here was added in response to regulations that were planned out as far as knowing when those regulations would take place and being enacted. These things would certainly take a number of years, 4 or 5 years, to produce something like this.
But given the right amount of time, now that this is up and running, how much SO2 does it take out of the process?
This removes 95% of the sulfur dioxide from flue gas, both units.
So given technology time to work, we're at about a 95% success rate.
Yes.
And that's what we're looking at with the test stuff over now with the CO2. There it is. What are we looking at now? Now that we're up here a little ways, how high up are we?
We're probably about 85 feet up. And what you can see here is this is a real good vantage point, Stephen, to see the carbon capture pilot here.
Carbon capture is a pipe dream. It's not happening anywhere. It's not in full scale. You know, you've read the stories. Your answer is you just have to go like that, right?
Well, what we see here is the pilot. It's a field demonstration. It's an operating carbon capture facility. And yes, it's in its infancy, but it is real.
Our pilot plant treats about 1.5% of one power plant here.
Right.
Two units. And we capture about 90% of the CO2.
Just for accuracy purposes, you're only pulling in 1%, but from that 1%, you're able to capture up to 90% of the CO2 from the 1% that you're pulling from the plant itself.
That's correct.
So I think people don't, when they hear about it, they're hearing that you're only capturing 1%, which isn't true at all. You're getting almost 90%, if not 90%.
90% efficiency, sometimes higher.
All right, so we're heading out of Pleasant Prairie, Wisconsin. Behind me is P4, where we just witnessed one of the first ventures outside the laboratory of a new technology used to capture CO2. We're gonna head back in the car and go to our next destination. Until then, those are the facts.